This is a beautiful world.
I'm Heather McElhattan, and this is A Beautiful World.
I study the very rarest butterflies in the world. The situation for them is very bleak. They are on the edge of extinction.
Nick Haddad is a professor of integrative biology at Michigan State University. He lives in Kalamazoo. His new book is called The Last Butterflies, A Scientist's Quest to Save a Rare and Vanishing Creature.
These butterflies number in the thousands and sometimes in the hundreds.
Nick and scientists like him are focused on saving butterflies, and six butterflies in particular, the six rarest species on Earth: the Bay Checkerspot, Fender's Blue, Crystal Skipper, the Miami Blue, St. Francis Satyr, and the rarest butterfly in the world, Schaus's Swallowtail, whose habitat is sadly found in the sprawling metropolis of Miami. All six species together, all six butterflies combined, there are only about 3,000 left.
I could squish them down, fit them all into a ball that's the size of a softball. And so this is almost no butterflies. They're so close to extinction that we're just doing all we can to try to avoid the inevitable loss of the species.
Haddad discovered butterflies not only need habitat to survive, they need whole ecosystems that get disturbed from time to time.
An Army base in North Carolina, Fort Bragg, they called me asking, can you help us with this endangered species, the St. Francis Satyr butterfly? The thing I learned later that's fascinating about this butterfly is it lives primarily in artillery impact areas. They're firing live artillery and bombs. And so it was this crazy scenario where the butterfly was living in what seemed like the worst place for it to live, and it turned out to be the best place for it.
This is due to the strange and poetic fact that these delicate butterflies actually need fire and flood to survive. The floods create wetlands, and the fires combine disparate colonies. Butterflies need what happens naturally in whole ecosystems, and what man has worked tirelessly to eliminate.
If I track through the history of all the rarest butterflies, their habitat is being lost because we're covering them with cities or fields. And, you know, they're down to the last little places on the face of the earth.
Restoring habitat, replenishing food sources, recreating natural disturbances, and hand-rearing butterflies in greenhouses are scientists' main techniques to improve butterfly numbers. The main thing that citizens can do is increase habitat and butterflies' food source.
What I learned is that I couldn't take a hands-off approach, that these natural disturbances are needed. And so my students and I created big experiments where we disturbed places, we cut trees, we flooded areas, but then saw the butterflies rebound. And so in those places, the populations have grown and grown and grown.
Now a quarter of the world's population of the St. Francis Satyr resides in the landscape that Nick and his team have altered. Nick stresses it's not enough to want to help. Taking action is the only thing that will help butterflies survive.
What I like to encourage people to do is set aside just a little bit of their yard to add flowers for pollinators and butterflies, or food plants for butterfly caterpillars. If everybody does a little bit, it really does add up.
Doing just a little bit can mean a lot.
My idea of a beautiful world is one where nature is connected. But we have to have nature that's incorporated into our working lands and urban landscapes as well.
You can find out more about The Last Butterflies online at abeautiful.world. I'm Heather McElhattan, and this is A Beautiful World, NPR News.
Brought to you with help from the Pollard Family Foundation.